Tesla Autopilot for me is one of the greatest features of owning a Tesla. However, a lot of the shortcuts and commands for Tesla Autopilot are not known by everyone. So today's video, we're going to be going into what these hidden commands are, because they will make your life so much easier. This first one, I'm just going to get out of the way because people are going to be searching how do I turn on autopilot through Google and YouTube, and this video is likely going to come up for them. So to engage it, one click down engages what we call cruise control, distance cruise control. But if you want to engage autopilot, which moves the steering wheel, two clicks down and that will engage autopilot. Now, many people get annoyed with cruise control and autopilot because you can't go above the speed limit on its basic settings. And this is because it knows the speed information from the sat nav information, but also it reads the road signs from this front camera. Now, to override the speed limit so you can go faster than the speed limit. Now, there's a few reasons why you want to do this. One, you just like to speed. Or two, some people in some countries allow 10% before you get a ticket. And to be honest, most speedos on cars aren't designed to be absolutely perfect. So to change it so you can mess around the speed limit, you hit this car icon down the bottom right, and you just go into the autopilot settings here. Now, this is the same menu where if you had full self-driving, you could enable basically drive on autopilot so it would follow the change lanes on motorways and stuff like that. But when we're in this menu, if we go here, we've got set speed, speed limit, and we've also got set speed, current speed. And then we've got the offset. And then we've got the offset, you can either fix it, so you can do just 2 miles an hour over, or you can set it as a percentage. Now, at the moment, mine is minus 24% for some reason, no idea why. And we're gonna set it to plus 4%, so we can go plus 4% over the speed limit. So if, for example, you're doing, some examples here, 35 means 36 and 65 means 68, and that's with a 4% limit. And if you want to set it to a 10% limit, because many people in the UK like to believe they can get away with 10%, 10% is 35 goes to 38 and 10% 65 to 71. So it gives you a little bit of a fluctuation there at 10%. But you can just set it for a fixed speed, like 2 miles an hour over, if you knew your speedo was slightly off. Because at the end of the day, most car manufacturers' speedos are not calibrated like the police speedos are. They're calibrated regular, cars are not. But we now know how to go above the speed, but how do you actually increase the speed when you're on autopilot and when you're on cruise control? There is a couple of ways of changing speed in the Model 3, and the quickest and most known one is you can actually hit the speed sign that the car's detected and it will change to that speed sign straight away. However, that is fine in most situations, apart from the situation that we're about to just encounter now, which is we're about to go past a speed van, which is literally after the speed sign. So the last thing we want to do is go through there at a higher speed. We want to change down slightly before the sign. And one way of doing this used to be hitting plus and minus on the dash, but they've removed that on the latest holiday update. So to do it now is the right-hand scroll wheel. You can scroll down to change the speed down and scroll up to change it up. It also has another massive advantage over the old rubbish screenway, which is A, it's less distracting, but it's also faster because you can change now at 5 degree increments. If you scroll it really fast, it'll go up by 5, and if you scroll it down really fast, it will go down by 5. So you get a lot more control over the speed on this. Now, that's not the only thing the scroll wheel does. The scroll wheel does a couple of other things. It changes the cruise distance and also autopilot distance from the car in front. So what I mean by that is you can set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 car lengths distance from the car in front, and you do that by pushing the arrow forward and backwards. So if you push it to the left, it will increase the distance up to 7 lengths, and if you push it all the way to the right, it will make you a lot closer, all the way down to what we call 1 van driver distance from the front of your car. Now, you've had a car before with cruise control and adaptive cruise, you'll know traditionally by pressing the brake or pressing the accelerator, it will disengage cruise control. On the Tesla, it's not fully true. So if you press the accelerator, it will just increase the speed and override the cruise control, and also override, say there was a car it was going to brake for I'll slow down for. If you hit the accelerator, it will override that slowing down or braking function. If you let go of the accelerator, it goes, returns back to normal cruise, and it will do whatever it was supposed to do. If you hit the brake, yes, it still does disengage exactly the same as any normal car, and that is a safety feature, built-in safety feature. However, when you hit the brake, it will turn the brake lights on. And if you're on a highway or a motorway, if like me, I never brake on the motorway, and I believe you never should, because it just causes tailbacks. So the easiest way, the safest way to disengage autopilot, if you know you're going to have to disengage it, and here in England, the most common myth, you know, reason why I disengage it is one, so I can use regen instead of braking if I saw the traffic was slowing down, or the main reason is cars tend to be parked on the left-hand side of the road here, and instead of the emergency brake slamming on, I want to cruise past it and just disengage cruise control. So the easiest way of doing that is just hitting the drive shifter up once. So to hit it as if you're going to neutral, and that will just disengage autopilot. You can't put it in neutral while you're driving, so don't worry. So you just press it up once and that will turn it off. Do not press the park button. Now it will disengage if you press it lightly just once, but if you hold it down, it will apply an emergency brake. So don't hit the park button. You just want to hit the gear shifter up once and that will disengage it. Now the gear shifter does do other things. If you have full self-driving, the shifter does other things like agreeing to lane changes, agreeing that the lights are green, agreeing that the lights are red. But I don't believe in full self-driving. I did a video all about why I don't think you should do it and why I think you should buy Tesla shares with the money instead, because in my mind it's a better investment. If you're thinking of buying Tesla shares, well, I've actually partnered with a company which have free trading, so you don't have to pay any trading fees for buying shares. The trading account I currently use for trading shares actually was charging me a commission, so I'll be moving all my shares over to this account. If you want a link to that, it's evnick.com/free share. And the reason it's free share is you get a free share when you sign up. It could be a random share, it could be any share, it could be a Tesla share if you're very, very lucky. But you can just get a random share, I think up to the value of 250. So if it's a Tesla share, they'll give you just a proportion of a Tesla share. I hope this video is very interesting for you. If you've liked it, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to check out my other videos, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.